Hey everyone, welcome to another video of Roman Just Codes. I'm Roman, and in this two-part video tutorial of the Angular PWAs and Google Maps series, I'll pick up where I left off on the previous video and continue implementing real-time location updates using Google Maps and Firebase Cloud Firestore. In part one of this video tutorial, we implemented the watch position method from the HTML5's geolocation API, out of which we get the user's coordinates from their device as they move. With all of that hooked up and working as expected, let's implement now the recipient side of things. Back in our map code, I'll start by making some tweaks to the size of the pins, as I noticed a bit of shifting as the pins moved and were not properly centered on the road. I'll adjust the anchor, add an origin, and make them a bit smaller than before. I'll replicate this change to the others. I'll also do some refactoring on this method since I need this portion of code here that updates the source pin location, because I'll use it in several places in this code. I'll extract it as a method, which I'll conveniently call setUpSourcePin. No changes, it will just continue doing the same thing. It's just that after updating the source location, I'll just run it, so it calls the setPosition with the updated location on the driver's pin. I'll remove the map centering piece as I won't need it here. I believe now I'm ready to add the portion of the code that listens for the updates on the document inside of the location updates collection. As the location is updated, as the driver moves and pushes the updated lat and long, whoever is listening on that document will get what's called a snapshot of that document. You hook it up by saying firestore.collection, pass the collection name, then .doc, passing the document name just like before. Now you say .ref, which gives you a reference or a pointer to that document. Then .onSnapshot, which takes a callback through which you can get a snapshot of the document you just queried. This snapshot is like an envelope that brings the document inside, so you have to unwrap it. I'll store it on a local variable called updatedSourceLocation, and I unwrap it using the snapshotsData method. By calling the .data method, you get this whole object from this document inside this collection. Now, let's do a little bit of logic for when who is listening is the package receiving user. This information, as you recall, is stored inside the document, but under the destination portion. So we'll check if we indeed have a destination portion in this document, and if its UID matches the person who just logged in. If so, these are the actions that we will have to do, in this order. Update the map, and by this we mean the map directions renderer. Set the route information once. Yes, we don't want to have to call the directions API on the receiving end, since we already did it on the driver's side. This is an expensive call. Of course, update the driver's pin on our version of the map with the incoming driver's location information. This is what keeps things in sync on both ends. I'll set the default options of suppressing the polylines to false and telling the directions renderer on which map to render the directions. We need to set the route information on the package recipient's end, but the driver hasn't pushed it, so let's do that first. Let's go down to the point where the driver invokes the Directions API service and gets the route information. Right here, we get the response object from the Directions API, and then we set it on the driver's map. This same response is what we want to set on the recipient's map as well, So let's avoid making another expensive call to the directions API and instead store the route information on Firebase so we can pick it up on the other end. Let's do a quick simulation where I'll simulate the driver moving along the route path. As before, I'll check whether the authenticated user is the driver, and then I'll push the relevant information. Let's push the route information to Firebase. Very simple. On the designated collection, inside of the document in question, we'll update the route field by typing set and passing just the route object. And I'll JSON serialize it so I can store it as a string. I'll store it with a merge true option. This piece of code right here, just like before, will update the route field in the Firebase document that both driver and recipient are sharing. I'll paste here some quick code that I put together to extract the coordinates inside of the Directions API route response. The Directions API response already returns a response which contains an array of all the coordinates that make up the whole route. A route contains something called a leg. You can have one or more legs in a route. A leg in route terms are like mini routes divided by waypoints or landmarks along the route. A leg contains something called steps, which are the individual coordinates that make up a leg. Now, I'm going to simulate the driver moving along the path and constantly pushing their location to Firebase, so other clients, in our case, the package receiving user, gets that updated location in real time. The same thing I did with the watch position method, but I'll do it here for the sake of this simulation. Same as before, get the reference to the collection, then to the document. Then I send to Firebase the initial location coordinates by setting the source portion of the document containing the updated lat and long coordinates. Pass the UID as well, so I can make sure that this is the user associated with the source location. I'll do a quick refactoring here on the fly. Instead of sending the route in a separate call as the source location to Firebase, I'll send both route and location on the same call. This definitely optimizes the updating of the data in Firebase by making fewer calls and cleans up the code as well. I'll update it using the merge true option. Now both route and source will be updated in the document without overwriting the rest in the same call. Remember from before that I can update one or many fields in a Firebase document, so this is how you can do it. Notice in Firebase that the route is empty now, but once the driver logs in and sets their position, this route field as well as the source below will be populated. I'll paste a little bit more code in here to complete the simulation, so let me explain what's going on here. The simulation will entail me sending all location coordinates obtained from the route returned from the directions API call at a 1 second interval until I don't have any more. So I'll grab one step of the single route leg available in the route, grab all the lat and longs inside the step, and every second, I'll push each value up to Firebase, thus simulating the driver moving along the route and constantly updating their location as if they were really moving. I'm pretty much mimicking the behavior of the watch position method. I'll create some other member variables that I'm missing to support this simulation. I'll need one to hold the set interval reference. And let me real quick clean up that reference before I forget. This lat-longs local variable will hold all location coordinates available from the route's lag step as shown before. And before the end of the set interval call, remember, after each second, after pushing the value to Firebase, I have to update the driver's pin locally as well. So I move one point, I push that point, so the other user gets it. I move another point, I push it, and so on. I do this by overriding the source location member variable and thus updating the source pin by calling my refactored method setup source pin. Okay, let's build the whole project. Let's open two instances of the same application running side by side. On the left, I'll log in as one user, which will be the driver. On the right, I'll log in as the package receiving user, checking how far their package is from their location. The driver goes in, sets their location. The simulated code's set interval starts running, and every 1 second pushes a single location. The other user logs in, and boom, they get the route information and immediately see in real time where the delivery truck with their package is, how far it is, and even how it moves closer and closer to them. Take a look at the Firebase console, how our shared Firebase document flashes as each update is pushed to it. Firebase is robust enough to take that many requests at high intervals, plus the ability to dispatch those same changes to whoever is subscribed or listening to them with very low latency. Thanks to the power of Firebase, Cloud Firestore, Google Maps, and the Places and Directions API. Well, I hope you learned a lot in both part 1 and 2 of this video tutorial, as much as I enjoyed making it for you. And I hope you can start using Firebase Cloud Firestore for your real-time communication needs in future projects. See you on the next one. That's it for this video, so please stay tuned for more upcoming videos. Hit the subscribe button to stay updated, and please like this video if you found it useful. Thank you so much for watching.